back at you again. Man, I appreciate all y'all for coming through and rocking with me. 1,500 subscribers. Oh my God, I cannot believe it. So, I wanted to go on the road to 2K, but I don't know if we're going to hit 2K by the end of the year. I don't know. Anything is possible. But we shooting for 2K 2020. I'm shooting for 4K, you feel me? But anyway, if you're new over here, make sure you hit that subscribe button. Like I said, 2020, we on the road to 4K. Trying to hit 2K, but it is what it is, man. Now, the year is almost up. 2019 has been one for the books. It's been an amazing decade, to say the least. But 2019 specifically has been awesome, besides my leg, but 2019 was still good to your boy. So anyway, I'm gonna go ahead and get into it. My top five pickups from 2019, these are my personal pickups. This is my opinion. This is what I wanted to go after. So without further ado, let's go ahead and get into number five. Number five, Turbo Green Ones. The Turbo Green Ones are, these might be sleepers if you ask me. A lot of people said they didn't like these. They sold out, but they came out All-Star Weekend. A lot of people said they didn't like these, and I know a lot of people picked these up and ended up selling them. But oh my God, like with me living in Charlotte now and going to the Hornets games and coming up in that era of Alonzo Mourning, Grandmama, Larry Johnson, like, I just had to pick these up, man, just because of, you know, how I grew up, man. That OG Hornets colorway, I just had to pick these up, man. So, number five, you got your Turbo Green Ones. These are one of the most these are sleeper. And I'm going to make a sleeper video, too, just for y'all. These are definitely a sleeper, and I'm glad I was able to pick these up during All-Star. All right, coming in at number four, we got another pair of ones, man. The Bozo the Clowns, aka the Fearless Ones, UNC to Chicago. This is another sneaker a lot of people didn't like, but this was one that was just calling my name. I had to have these, man. I'm surprised I picked them up. I usually don't like patent leather on ones, but this one right here was just something I had to have, like, off the rip when I first saw the pictures. Like I said, a lot of people didn't like the colorway, the color blocking, with the red going into the UNC blue, the Carolina blue. But me being a Carolina blue fan, a Carolina blue guy, UNC guy, I had to pick these up, man. And y'all know Jordan is like Jordan the GOAT, so why not? Like, if you're a sneakerhead, these had to be in your collection. So coming in at number four, Fearless Ones. And these are still dead stock, by the way. A lot of my stuff dead stock. But 2020, I definitely plan on wearing my stuff, man. Especially when I get my leg right, I'm going to be going different places. So, hey, we just out here 2020. 2020, we on the move, baby. Coming in at number three. Number three, y'all know I had to put a Kyrie in this thing, man. Kyrie Preheat. Whew. I just had to have these, man. I actually forgot the name of these. I can't believe I forgot the name of them. Now, I have worn these. I got a blue polo outfit, navy blue polo outfit that I wear with these, and I wish I would have got a 12 and a half in these, because the Kyrie 6's fit kind of tight, but I couldn't find the 12 and a half on GOAT. Got these off the GOAT app. These came out with the City Edition Kyrie 6's, the 11-11 joints, and y'all know how my boy, y'all know Kyrie my boy. I love me some Kyrie, man. That's my favorite current basketball player. Well, Melo's back now, so Melo's still in that thing, you feel me? But yeah, man, I did a review on these when I first got them from GOAT. Shout out to the GOAT app. And I just love these sneakers. I just wish I would have got them in a 12 and a half. But overall, I mean, the 12 is like an exact fit. As far as hooping in these, when I get back right, I probably won't hoop in these. I wore these to a basketball game, and everybody was like, man, where you got those joints from? Like, I'm like, man, I can't even tell y'all. You know, I don't like to tell everybody where I get my stuff from. But if you're watching the video, I mean, you kind of know now, you feel me? So coming in at number three, Kyrie Preheat Heal the World. So my number two sneaker, I thought I had it in the car with me, but I do not have it with me. And I got two pairs of them, so I know y'all like, dang, go. How you got two pairs of the sneaker and they ain't in your drop fronts? Well, I left them at my girl house. But coming in at number two are the Bred 11s. Now, that's my favorite basketball sneaker of all time, my favorite Jordan of all time. Like, I just love that sneaker. But as far as 2019, it came in at number two on my pickup list. Everybody went crazy over these, as usual, in December. The 11s, they always sell out. It don't matter what colorway, 11s are always going to sell out. The only recent 11 that sat were the Platinum 10s. Those sat for a minute. And I kind of want to get a pair of those just to get them customized. I got a pretty good idea how I want to do them things, you feel me? But coming in at number two, you got the Bread 11. All right, number one, my number one pickup. If you a fan of me and if you've been watching me for a minute, you already know what I'm about to pick up or what I picked up for 2019. Whoo, boy. Travis Scott sixes. Let y'all get some of that thing, man. Now, I might not wear these until 2022. It's going to be a minute before I wear these. And when the yellow joints come out, I'm hoping to strike on the yellow joints too. But number one, the Travis Scott sixes. After many failures, and y'all gonna see my L's for 2019, but I did not hit on the Travis Scott ones. And I initially didn't like the sixes when we first got pictures of them. I'm like, man, I ain't gonna buy that shoe. I ain't gonna get that shoe. But nothing beats a failure but a try. I missed the Travis Scott ones, which were the ones I definitely wanted, and ended up hitting on these. And I thought about selling these, but I'm like, man, nah, I'm gonna sell these for. I'm keeping these joints. This might be the most heat. This might be the hottest thing I have in my collection. So coming in at number one. But now, number one are my Travis Scott sixes. This might be the hottest sneaker I got in my collection. But I'm gonna try to change that for 2020. 2020, I need all the heat. I need that Airship, Jordan 1 pack. I need the Canary Yellow. Ooh, them Canary Yellow Off-White ones, I need them. I'm about to get some fire in my collection, you feel me? But anyway, once again, I appreciate y'all for coming through and rocking with your boy, your friendly neighborhood sneaker man, Goat Weezy. It's always love, baby. I appreciate y'all, man. Got some big things planned for 2020. We about to blast off, y'all. We about to blast off like a Houston Rocket. You know, we about to turn the thing into a franchise, man. You feel me? But like I said, I appreciate y'all for coming through. I love y'all. And y'all know how I get out of here, baby. Love, peace. And with all this beef, put some chicken grease on that thing. Gone.